makes them behave this way.
هنيئاً لكم يا من صمتم شهر رمضان. هنيئاً لكم بامتثالكم لأمر ربكم. كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. هنيئاً لكم بامتثالكم لأمر نبيكم. من صام رمضان إيماناً واحتساباً غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. ومن قام رمضان إيماناً واحتساباً غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. A glad tidings to you, those who have observed the month of Ramadan, responding to the call of Allah as He commanded us to do so in the Quran when He said that Siyam has been prescribed on you as it has been prescribed on those who came before you. And glad tidings to you as you have also responded to the call of your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said to us that whoever fasts the month of Ramadan seeking the pleasure from Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah will forgive his sins. And those who also will be doing the Qiyam, referring to Salat al-Taraweeh, then Allah will be forgiving their sins. And those who have observed Laylatul Qadr, that they have gained a lot of rewards, as it is Laylatul Khayrun min al-Bishar. Indeed, this is the ultimate goal of the mu'min. We've observed this beautiful season of Rahamat from the month of Rajab. And we continued after that in the month of Sha'ban. And Alhamdulillah, Allah blessed us to be from those who have witnessed the month of Ramadan. Though there has been a few who were not as lucky as we might have been, as Allah Azza wa Jalla have taken their amana before the month of Ramadan or during the month of Ramadan. So Alhamdulillah, that we're still breathing, that we're still alive, and we are guided to His deen. Alhamdulillah, that we are coming to the masajid. We are observing those beautiful chances that Allah would be giving to us around the year. And as Allah Azza wa Jal indicated in the Quran in a chapter that is titled by Al-Mu'minun, يَا أَيُّهَا الرُّسُلُ كُنُوا مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَاعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ عَلِيمٌ. As Allah Azza wa Jal indicated to us in this chapter, which He refers to us as mu'minun, wants us to be from the mu'minun, those who قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Oh, he addressed the prophets, referring to us, those who are followers of the prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal. All prophets of Allah, كُلُوا مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ, eat from the good that Allah has provided to you, وَاعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا, and do the good. إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ عَلِيمٌ. As I am aware and observing of what you're doing, and in the set of ayah that Allah Azza wa speaks about those who are very vigilant, those who are very observant, and those who are very mindful, and those who are intellectual in the way they look into this beautiful gift that Allah has given to them that is called life. And Allah Azza wa said about them, أولئك والذين يؤتون ما أتوا وقلوبهم وجلة أنهم إلى ربهم راجعون أولئك يسارعون في الخيرات وهم لها سابقون ولا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها ولدينا كتاب ينطق بالحق وهم لا يظلمون. Those الذين هم من خشية ربهم مشفقون والذين هم بآيات ربهم يؤمنون والذين هم بربهم لا يشركون والذين يؤتون ما أتوا وقلوبهم وجلة أنهم إلى ربهم راجعون. Those who are very mindful, very aware that there is something for them in this life. This life is not only for us to eat and sleep and work and seek the pleasures and the entertainments of this dunya. This is just one of the things that Allah has made this dunya for. But there's an ultimate goal to the mu'min in this dunya, which is al-amal salih. Before it is too late, before that Allah Azza will be saved, we will be in that position which Allah described in the Quran, قَالَ رَبِّ رُجِعُونَ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا. We don't want to be from those who at the time of their departing from this dunya will be wishing that Allah will be giving them another chance. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا, so that I may not go and have another degree, not go and get another house, or a second mortgage, or like a second, a better car, but أعمل صالحا, to do good for you, Ya Rabbi Al-Alameen. And as we have, Alhamdulillah, concluded the month of Ramadan, we need not to look backward, but rather we need to look forward.
We need not to say that how we can maintain the level of ibadah we have involved in during the month of Ramadan. Brother, we want to be from those who would say, how can I build on what I have established throughout the month of Ramadan? How can I be from as-sabaqun fil khayrat? We have worked very hard through the 29 or 30 days of the month of Ramadan to push ourselves, to control our whims and our desires so that we're able to come to Allah Azza wa Jal. You've come that far and you've reached that level. Don't go backward, but rather aim to get further higher in your relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal. Be from those who will be insha'Allah aiming to fast 6 days from the month of Shawwal, as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam indicated that this is Siyam al-Dahr. And let also be from those from today, but rather from the month of Rajab, aiming towards that the best days of the whole year, as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam indicated that ما من أيام, no days of the whole year, the good deeds are highly evaluated by Allah Azza wa Jal, like the days of the Dhul Hijjah. Those are the days in which we need to be from now ready and prepared to benefit from. These are the days that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam clearly indicated that no days of the whole year, including the month of Ramadan, the good deeds are highly evaluated by Allah, like these days, yes, Ya Rasulullah. And these are the days in which Allah Azza wa Jal have made an oath by in Surah Al-Fajr, Wal-Fajr, Wal-Layal, Al-Ashr, Wal-Shaf'i, Wal-Watr. These are the days in which Allah Azza wa Jal have made an oath by for their value. So let us be from those who will be aiming high and the highest they can go by preparing ourselves to be from those who will be, insha'Allah, trying to make it to the old house of Allah Azza wa Jal. Responding to the call that Allah Azza wa Jal initiated on Ibrahim's time thousands of years ago, when Allah said in the Quran, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ. لماذا يا رب؟ ليشهدوا منافع لهم ويذكروا اسم الله على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام. Let us be from those who always looking and seeking to be from as-sabaqun to Allah Azza wa Jal. To be from those who would not miss any chance that would make them from those who will be coming close to Allah. Those who will be gaining al-Jannah. Those who will be seeking the forgiveness. Let us be from those who will respond to the call of Allah Azza wa Jal. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا ومن كفر فإن الله غني عن العالمين. Let us not be from those whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that whoever had the financial and physical ability and do not make it to Hajj without any legitimate reason or burden to stop you, prevent you from going to Hajj, let him not bother to die as a non-Muslim. This is how beautiful this ritual is. This is one of the pillars of the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. So let us be from those who would say, Ya Rabbi, I want to be from those who are eager, Ya Rabbi, to make it your own house of Allah. I want to do it, Ya Rabbi, because I have not been able to do it. I am working from today, Ya Rabbi, whether it is this year or the year to come, Ya Rabbi, but I want to start with the niyyah today, at the moment. Ya Rabbi, I was not able to do it. I want to do it, Ya Rabbi. I want to respond to your call, Ya Rahman. I want to be from your wafd, Ya Rabbi. Because wafd al-Rahman, the wafd of Allah Azza wa Jal, are those who prepare themselves to go to the house of Allah, responding to the call in the Quran, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ. I want to be, Ya Rabbi, from those who have responded to call your call and will be privileged, to be from those whom you will be answering their calls, answering their dua, responding to their needs, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Al-Hujjaj wal-Ummar wa Fdullah
سألهم فأجابوه ودعاهم فأجابوه وسألوه فأعطاهم.
You have responded to the call of Allah and you have come to His old house. Allah Azzal will be giving you what you have wished for.
And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam indicated in a long hadith that يُغْفَرُ الْحَاجِ وَلِمَنْ أَسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُ الْحَاجِ.
Allah Azzal will be forgiving to the haji and to the ones that the haji will be seeking forgiveness for.
So let us be from those who are eager to be from those who will be planning. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also indicated that عَبْدًا a servant صَحَحْتُ لَهُ جَسَدًا I have given him the health and I give him the wealth and do not come to my old house after 5 years, within 5 years, then لَمَحْرُوم then he is a mahroom, mahroom from the ajr, mahroom from the rewards that Allah Azza wa Jalla has prepared to those who are eager to come closer to him.
إن عبداً صححت له جسمه ووسعت عليه في المعيشة تمضي عليه 5 أعوام لا يفد إلي أنا محروم.
Indeed, a mahroom. Just like what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said about ليلة القدر.
من حرم خيرها فقد حرم. Those who have missed out in ليلة القدر are indeed محروم
from the rewards and from the barakat and the rahmat of ليلة القدر.
Let us be from those هُمَا لَبَّ مُلَبِّنْ
that whenever you call to the respond of to the call of Allah Azza wa Jalla by saying
لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ لَبَّيْكَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَكَ لَبَّيْكَ إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ وَالنِّعْمَةَ لَكَ وَالْمُلْكَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَكَ
لَبَّيْكَ يَا رَبِّ. This poor servant of yours, Ya Rabbi, standing between your hands, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen, responding to you as the servant, as the slave would respond to the call of his master. You are the king of all the kings. You are the master of all the masters. Ya Rabbi, I am humbling myself. I'm humiliating myself between your hands, Ya Rabbi Al-Alameen. I'm coming to you, Ya Rabbi, Labbayka. Responding to you, Ya Rabb. I am at your command, Ya Rahman. I am leaving behind my family, my wealth, my business, everything. Ya Rabbi, I am even coming to the point where I am taking everything belongs to this dunya, including my stitched clothes. And I'm coming to you wrapped with my shrouds, as if I am coming to you, Ya Rabbi, in the kafan. Ya Rabbi, hoping that you will be accepting me. Hoping that I will be from those ma malabba mulabbin. No mulabbin will be responding in talbiya, except that a hajar or a shajar, a stone or a tree will be responding to his talbiya until you reach your final destination. Let us be from those who are so eager to come to the old house of Allah Azza wa Jalla, hoping that this visit, hoping that this trip will make a difference in their life, in this dunya, and in the akhirah. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam indicated to the sahabis that came asking him about the rewards of Hajj and said to them that with every step your camel walks by, you get a hasana, a sayyi'ah will be erased from you. With every step you walk as you intend to leave for Hajj, leaving from your home, as you walk to your car and drive to the airport and fly all the way to the old house of Allah Azza wa Jal. Translate that to khatawat, to steps, and think of how many thousands rather than millions of hasanat you will be gaining as you are coming to Allah Azza wa Jal. How many of the sayyi'at will be erased from you? And as you make your tawaf around the old house of Allah Azza wa Jal, knowing that your tawaf in this earth is done along with the malaika who are doing their tawaf in al-bayt al-ma'mur, where 70,000 angels every day come to do their tawaf, and they depart and never make it back until the day of judgment. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ And no one knows the count of your soul, the soldiers of Allah Azza wa Jal, except Him. Knowing that you are doing the tawaf that has been done by your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Chances you will be walking in the footsteps that the Prophet ﷺ walked. Chances you will be walking on the footsteps that the prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal, all after Ibrahim, have did the tawaf around the Bayt al-Haram. Because all the prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal, as the Prophet ﷺ indicated, that Musa alayhi salam and Isa alayhi salam have made it to the old house of Allah Azza wa Jal and did their Hajj. Knowing when you are looking at the house of Allah Azza wa Jal and perceiving Al-Hajar Al-Aswad, which is a part of Al-Jannah, your heart is longing and looking forward to the real Jannah, as you see a physical part and piece from Al-Jannah in front of you in this dunya. And as you finish your tawaf, you pray to Allah Azza wa Jalla to rukah behind the post of Ibrahim if this is possible. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam indicated, فَلَكَ بِذَلِكَ عِفْقُ رَقَبًا. The rewards of doing so will be freeing a raqaba, will be freeing, setting someone free. And this is a beautiful reward from Allah Azza wa Jal. And then when you go to drink from the water of Zamzam, knowing that Zamzam lima shuriba lahu, Zamzam is what it was intended for, whether it is that Allah Azza wa Jal give you the forgiveness, or whether it is that Allah Azza wa Jal give the shifa to you physically, or mentally, or spiritually, whether it is to seek the knowledge of the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal, whatever you intend from this trip, whatever you have in your mind will be inshallah answered to you by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal. Zamzam lima shuriba lahu. And then when you proceed to do your sa'i between the Safa and the Marwa, remembering the actions of Hajar alayha salam, remembering her being alone in the desert, no one around her, after she had exhausted her calls to Ibrahim alayhi salam, calling him and saying, إِلَا مَنْ تَكِلُنَا يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ. Whom do you leave us for, Ya Ibrahim? And Ibrahim alayhi salam responding to her, and then should she come back her conscience and said, أَمَّهُ أَمَرَكَ بِذَلِكَ. And he nodded to her, yes. And then she said her famous word, which became a word that all of us keep in their hearts and mind. إِذَنْ لَنْ يُضَيِّعَ اللَّهِ. Allah would not let us alone. Remember and think of Hajar alayhi salam, who was in desperate condition, desperate situation with her breastfed infant, who was crying, and she was frantically trying to find a help and support for him. Think of the situation she went through. Think of all the circumstances that she went through, and think of all the feelings that came to her mind and heart, and think of her iman in Allah Azza wa Jalla. Think of how, because of her iman, how she became later on an icon to millions every year, to billions around the time, who will be doing her actions in Hajj and Umrah. She was a true mu'min who set an example to the believers to come later on. No matter how difficult your situation is, no matter how dire your situation is, Allah is the one who says the things be and they will be. Allah is the most generous. If you make it to his old house, he would not let you back without responding to your call, without giving you the best of the dunya and the deen and the akhirah. وَيَدْعُوا الْإِنسَانُ بِالشَّرِّ دُعَاءَهُ بِالْخَيْرِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا. Allah will give you the best, whatever is best for you in the deen and the dunya. وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا.
Ya Rabbi, from your gracious bounties, Ya Rabbi, from your generosity, Ya Rabbi, from your rahmah, make us from those who will be blessed this year, Ya Rabbi, to stand on the mountain of Arafah, on the day of Arafah, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin, so that we will be from those whom when you come down to the lower sky and ask the malaika, you know best, what my servants have come for. And then when the malaika say, Ya Rabbi, they came looking for your rahmah maghfirah, seeking your jannah. And we will be asking, this is what they're asking for. They're asking for my jannah and they haven't seen it. What if they have seen it? And Allah Azza wa Jal will be saying, will be responding, will be telling us, I witnessed the malaika. I have forgiven them. I have forgiven them their sins and given them what they have wished for. And when Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, is this inclusive to those who are standing in the mountain of Arafah with you, Ya Rasulullah, at that particular time in Hajjah, in the Hajjah the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did? He said, no, it's for all those who come after you until the day of judgment. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, what a beautiful moment. Ya Allah, what a beautiful feeling you would have at the end of the day of Arafah, standing on the mountain of Arafah, knowing that this is the day of Maghfirah, knowing that no days of the whole year shaitan will be seen as humiliated, as you will be seen on the day of Arafah, as he sees the Rahman, the Maghfirah of Allah Azza wa Jal coming down on the servants. And when you do your jamarat, then Abu Biqat will be erased to you. Big sins will be gone from you. And when you slaughter, فَهُوَ مَدْخُورٌ لَكَ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ. Your slaughtering will be saved for you to Allah Azza wa Jal. Will be as is. None of the malaika will be able to translate it for Hasanah. And when you do your tawaf and ifada, you will do it as you were born the moment. And a malak will be standing behind you, pushing you, and say, go forward. Go forward in your life with sins forgiven. Allahu Akbar. What a beautiful ibadah. We pray to Allah Azza wa Jal that would make it possible to all of us. Allahumma inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala nabiyyi. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli 'ala Muhammadin wa 'ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita 'ala Ibrahim wa 'ala ali Ibrahim. وبارك اللهم على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم في العالمين انك حميد مجيد. اللهم انا ابناء عبيدك ابناء ايمانك نواصي نبيك ماض فينا حبك يا رب عدل فينا قضاءك يا رب نسالك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك انزلته في كتابك او علمته احدا من خلقك او استاثرت به في علم الغيب عندك بان تجعل القران العظيم ربيع قلوبنا يا رب اجعله جماعة لامومنا واحزاننا يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم ادعوك في هذا اليوم ندعوك في هذه الساعة المباركة يا رب ندعوك وقلوبنا وجلاء يا رب اكتب لنا حج بيتك الحرام يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يزورون بيتك الحرام مرات عديدة وكثرات مديدة. اللهم اكرمنا بصيام الست من شوال. اللهم اكرمنا بأن نعم وصالحا في العشر من الحجة يا رب العالمين. يا من علينا بالعافية يا رب. يا رب اكرمنا بالعتق من يا رب. اكتب لنا رفقة نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في فردوسك الأعلى من الجنة فإنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم إنا نتضرع إليك ونستغيث بك ونجأر إليك ونتضرع إليك يا رب بأن تنصر الإسلام والمسلمين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم فرج كربنا يا رب. اللهم فك أسرى أسرانا وداو جرحنا ومرضانا. اللهم فك أسرى علماء المسلمين. اللهم فك أسرى دعاة المسلمين. اللهم انصر دينك واجعلنا من جندك يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظ ابناءنا، احفظ بيوتنا، اللهم احفظنا بحفظك يا ارحم الراحمين. هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قره اعين واجعلنا من المتقين يا ربي. ربي اوزعني ان اشكر نعمتك التي انعمت علي وعلى والدي وان اعمل صالحا ترضاه يا رب واصلح لي في ذريتي اني تبت اليك وانني من المسلمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم.